The BRCA1 and BRCA2 genes, when they were identified, were actually identified because of the associated risk for breast cancer. And that's where the name came from. So BR standing for breast, and then CA standing for cancer, and then 1 and 2 simply standing for the order in which they were identified. Every individual carries these BRCA1 and 2 genes, so both men and women can be at risk for the cancers associated with this gene. And when there's a mutation in BRCA1 or BRCA2, there's specific cancer risks that we can see for an individual. Breast, ovarian, prostate, pancreatic, melanoma, as well as male breast cancer. It doesn't guarantee that an individual is going to develop a cancer, but we know that they're going to be at significantly higher risk than general population. It's really important for our men to understand the family history. Most men, when they're thinking about cancer risk, are focused on prostate cancer risk in the family, but often things like breast cancer in the family might be overlooked. And we know that that can play a role when we're thinking about evaluating a family for a BRCA1 or a BRCA2 mutation. If you're identified to have a BRCA mutation, it's not diagnosing you with a cancer. It's just indicating that there's a higher likelihood to develop cancer. So there's going to be increased surveillance that we're going to want to do to make sure that we're staying on top of that increased cancer risk. For a general population, if we're thinking about screening for prostate cancer, we know that that conversation is probably going to happen between 45 to 55. If somebody has a BRCA mutation, though, we're going to start screening a little bit earlier than we would otherwise. Right now, the guidelines are to start screening at age 40, with consideration for doing screening every year versus every other year, which is what we would tell somebody who's in the general population. There are two categories when it comes to considering genetic testing. One is going to be personal history of cancer, one is going to be family history of cancer. For an individual with a diagnosis of prostate cancer, there's very specific criteria. If somebody has metastatic disease, high risk or very high risk prostate cancer, they're going to qualify for genetic testing, as well as an individual who has prostate cancer and is Ashkenazi Jewish. This is going to have implications for screening for them, and this potentially could be something that they pass on to their sons and their daughters. Genetic testing can be a really powerful tool for our patients, and this can be a gift when it comes to that patient and their family and better understanding their cancer risks. And it's something that we can do through a blood or a saliva sample. It's a simple process, but it can have a big impact.